Me, I heard you, Ivo, loud and clear, and I need to discuss this. Ivo, my love, you heard me correctly. I said that getting angry seems to be the natural reaction to many of the behaviors you are accosted with, and perhaps you feel they deserve it, but ask yourself if you deserve your reaction to it. We are working on not reacting to others who seek to steal your energy, and to create lush, because this is what it is. This is why you saw Barry Littleton's video as a reminder of what this is all about. Nobody would behave the way they do on your planet except for the fact they are prompted to for the sake of creating lush in others. They are being prompted to create lush for their attachments, who might quickly jump to you for the sake of a meal. And for the same reason, your cat behaves as he does, he is also being prompted to wake you up while you are sleeping, get in your way while you are trying to sweep the floor in your art room, chase flies and upset the apple cart around him. He is a cat, yes, a feral animal, in his case, and an alpha, which makes him more difficult to deal with. Anyone is susceptible to creating lush for the dark ones, if they are at the correct vibrational frequency. Also, do not dismiss the impact that chemtrails have upon your psyche, plus the fact that you are cut off from sunlight. The dark ones know this and prompt the cabal to create these less than viable circumstances for your people. Yes, perhaps the person you are dealing with is of low consciousness. You look at your neighbor and cannot fathom the level of understanding she is at. She says she fears being alone, but she would rather live with someone who is threatening and abusive to her than be by herself. That is difficult to understand. Me, yes. Ivo, the other neighbor constantly puts you down. I have told you to ignore him and you are, however your opinion of him is lowering. Me, what's it supposed to do? Ivo, you need to forgive him. Understand, were it not for these attachments, he would not behave this way. Me, worst part is, his kid is listening to the way he talks to me. Ivo, this is very unfortunate. But the point I was making to you earlier is that you suffer the most. You suffer having to tolerate others' ill-gotten behaviors towards you, then you suffer your resentment, and then your angry outburst as you attempt to control them. So nobody wins except the non-visible non-incarnates surrounding you. You need to stop feeding them. Me, it would help if I wasn't having a chemtrail day. Ivo, tomorrow you will go and buy the painter's mask and make the appropriate mask for when you see chemtrails in the sky. You will be able to beat them at their game. You are also working with the violet flame to remove them from the sky when they appear. And this is working. You have not suffered as much as you had earlier because you are clearing the skies. Me, yeah, but I'll look like Darth Vader with the mask on. Ivo, what you look like is an ego affliction. It is that your health improves because that is what you are most in need of. Me, true. Ivo, this message is a reminder to all to stop trying to control others and attempt to control your reaction to them. This is the only way to remain above the chaos and craziness surrounding you. Especially those who are awake and on the ascension path and who are aware of what others are attempting to do to them, such as Sharon is, you need to work on the next steps of forgiveness, and perhaps you do not wish to spend time with these people, but you also should not spend time in unforgiveness. Jesus said, "Father, forgive them for they know not what they do," and nothing could be more true than that. However, for those who rise in awareness, you are now called on to walk the high road. Since you have ascended in awareness, you are now being called to ascend in behavior as well. It is not a path of understanding the higher message and ignoring it. Of course, you will have days when you are in a bad mood, especially if you are an empathy with endocrine problems. However, you will still be expected to overcome all with mind, because mind is stronger than body. Your body can no longer dictate to you what you can and cannot do. "Well, I am ill so I can treat others any way I want to," no longer holds water. That is an excuse. You are not a body. You are a consciousness, and the path of ascension is to be of higher consciousness, not lower consciousness. Me, I'm just wondering when my neighbor will stop his put downs. Ivo, he may never stop, my love, but to be honest, that is none of your business. Me, that's true. That's me on his side of the fence. I have to stay on mine. What do I plan to do about it? Ignore him and not to take on the shame he's trying to shoot at me. Ivo, mind is strong. Always. It is a question of practice. This is a lesson for all, especially now when your world is so divided in opinion. Opinion means nothing. There is only one truth, so find it and follow it. Me, thanks Ivo. Ivo, you realize you like to dominate as well. And in being this way, then who do you have to have around you but others you consider less than viable humans? Chaotic, incompetent humans who you compare yourself to. This must end. You are of higher consciousness and you do know better than they do, however your ego is in the way here. This is why you are holding on to your neighborhood, because your struggles with your neighbors feed your ego, and in so doing, they feed the feelings of separation and then in turn feed the New World Order agenda. No less than that. This is a lesson for all of you, stop comparing yourself as superior or inferior to others. This is the power over others system. The first indication you'll find that you are doing is your focus switches to others. Keep your focus on yourself, not on others. When you are unhappy, many of you switch your focus to others, and then blame them for making your life miserable. It is you that is making yourself miserable because of your reaction to them and your need for them to create the reaction of superiority or inferiority that your ego seeks. That is the simple fact. You need these people for your ego to create your false sense of self. That is why you react to them. You create your world, you create your happiness, and you are responsible for both. Your world encompasses all that you touch on, become aware of, that is your world. If that is a miserable existence, it is because you have allowed it to be. Yes. Me, I know my ego justifies it just because I find this world is so crazy. Ivo, when you can catch yourself in any cycle of thinking which manifests in certain behaviors, for example you feel the world is crazy and people are of low consciousness, especially those around you, so this makes you angry because you feel that were it not for your financial situation, you would move to a place that feels more sane to you. So then, you are angry at your circumstances and then you feel that you have the right, you feel justified, in treating them all the way you decide they deserve to be treated. You are all taught to do this. You feel that because others behave in low consciousness ways, perhaps they eat meat and you are a vegan, so you feel righteously justified in your anger, and when you come across a meat eater, you blast them with your anger and feel you have done the world a service. You have not. You have done nothing but create bad karma for yourself. And this will be rebalanced in your lifetime. What's more, you are beholden to that situation, attached to it. Lose your ego attachment and detach from situations which displease you. This is mastery of mind. Allow them to be and allow yourself to rise above them. We understand that you are in a difficult situation on your planet at this time, especially. And we realize we must repeat our messages to continue to remind you not to buy into old 3D behaviors if you wish to ascend. Your ego will justify everything as being correct and will give you emptiness and a sorry life in return for allowing it to dominate. You must overcome it. There are still dark ones about and you must learn to play your own game of life rather than playing theirs. You have learned to play theirs by behaving this way and now you must drop it. Also be very careful about any feeder activities that might feed into this entire ego syndrome. For example, if you watch videos on YouTube about fails. Yes. You see people having fails and your ego is thinking, oh, I would never be that stupid, or, look at these people. Are they serious? You are simply stoking the fires for this ego imbalance syndrome. Watch videos about those who have mastered their craft, such as professional piano players, or watch videos about people are awesome, who are good at extreme sports. But stay away from videos like America's Funniest Home Videos because these stoke the superiority syndrome. Be very careful what you expose yourself to. Watch whenever you see yourself laughing at another person's actions. Also, If you have feelings that your aircraft are not superior at all and too many of them crash or drop out of the sky, then do not watch Mayday episodes. This also feeds not only the ego syndrome but your fears. Any show where incompetence is exhibited feeds your ego because obviously you think you would never do that or be so stupid. This all must be avoided, otherwise you will stay in this ego misery. And basically, when this is directed at any other person, it is hateful. Yes. What's more, if you are prone to thinking this way, of attacking others in the name of feeling superior, do not read the news. The attacks launched on Donald Trump are part of the power over others control system, because they are in fact not attempting to obtain power over Donald Trump as much as their words to discredit him are attempts to continue their power over you. This is what you've learned as credible thinking, and it is anything but that. Those of higher consciousness who are aware, realize this and at least attempt to live this way. This is why so many are unable to see Donald Trump as being better than the news portrays him to be, because they too, live by and enact this power over others system. When you live it and love it, you enable others to live that way, even expect others to live that way, and allow them to control you in turn. In the same way, if you become angry at your neighbor, my love, then you create bad karma for yourself. It is about walking the higher road even if they do not. Because when you refuse to take the high road, you are on the same road as they are, one of low consciousness. Do you understand? Me, yep. Thank you, Ivo. Ivo, your state of health dictates nothing. You are not justified in being angry at others' behavior because you are in poor health. That is an excuse. Your people use too many of them, and therefore your world is on the fringe of erupting right now. Everyone must take responsibility for their own happiness.